Hi dear friends, in this session we are going to discuss about traveling salesman problem, flowcharts of transportation and assignment problems. Coming to the learning objectives, after this session you should be able to solve a traveling salesman or routing problem. They are one and the same. Understand the methodology of solving transportation problem and assignment problem by flowcharts. Traveling salesman problem, that is TSP, otherwise known as routing problem. Suppose a salesman has to visit several cities, needs to start from a particular city, visit each city once and then return to his or her starting point. The objective is to select the sequence in which the cities are visited in such a way that his or her total traveling time is minimized. Assume that a medical representative or a tourist or a salesperson has to visit n number of cities. Obviously, we'll start from a particular city known as home city, let us say. So, you will cover each and every city in between, okay, once and only once, and he or she will come back to the home city. Fine. So, in this process, what will happen is, if you have n number of cities, no, you will get n minus 1 factorial, different sequences or different routes. So imagine, okay, if you have 6 in between cities, no? 6 minus 1, that is 5 factorial, it is 120. 120 different sequences or 120 different routes you will get. So is it possible to check physically or conventionally all these routes? No, it is very tedious or very difficult. So hence, you have to use or devise a method to solve a traveling salesman problem or routing problem. So what I can say is, traveling salesman problem or routing problem is a special type of assignment problem. To solve an assignment problem, we have used a method known as Hungarian assignment method, HAM. Same concept we are going to use here also. Only thing is, one more additional constraint is to be satisfied. So the procedure of solving traveling salesman problem is very similar to the solving of assignment problem only, but one additional condition or constraint is to be satisfied. What is that? Okay, we'll see through a numerical. A medical representative has to visit 3 cities, 1, 2 and 3. The distances in hundreds of kilometers between the 3 cities are given below. Find the optimal sequence or optimal route. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. These are the cities. Okay, here also you have to write the same. So this is given data for you. Infinity, 8, 4, 8, infinity and so on. So now 8 means 800, 4 means 400 because it's given in hundreds of kilometers. Now what is the meaning of this infinity diagonally is? So traveling from same place to same place is undefined or is not meaningful, no? That's why okay, we'll put infinity. It's like a restricted assignment problem. So in the restricted assignment transportation problem, what we discussed is, so it is a special case, as a special case we discussed. So once, okay, if there is infinity or dash or something like, you are not supposed to allocate for that. So same way, it is like a restricted assignment problem now. So infinity, infinity. See, you can see 2 to 2 is infinity, 3 to 3 is infinity. Now, so let us recall the HAM, that is Hungarian assignment method. First step is row reduction. This is the given data. In each row, no, identify the least element, okay, or select the least element, subtract all other elements from it. For example, infinity minus 4. In this case, no, 4 is the least. Infinity minus anything is infinity. 8 minus 4 is 4. 4 minus 4, 0. Same thing you have to do it for other rows also. That is called row reduction. Okay, I mean this step is row reduction. Second step, column reduction. Same thing you have to do it for all the columns, all the three columns. Okay, once if it is reduced row wise and column wise, it is called RM, reduced matrix, which is ready for allocations. Now, okay, row wise if we scan, no, single zero you have. Okay, as you are scanning row wise, cancel the column. Second row, okay, cancel the column. Third row, cancel the column. Solution is optimal as number of allocations is equal to order of the matrix. Number of allocations are 3, 1, 2, 3. Order of the matrix is also 3, 3 cross 3. Hence, you can declare the optimality. Now, I was telling about one additional constraint in case of traveling salesman problem. What is that? Okay, we'll see. So, okay, no doubt it is optimal. So, a traveling salesman problem should be optimal as well as it should be feasible if you write the route. What is the meaning of feasible? We'll see. So optimal, okay, you got it. Whenever you get number of allocations is equal to order of matrix, no? Then you can say that it is optimal as per the assignment problem concerned. Fine. What is this feasible or feasibility is? Okay, if you form the route like chain, okay? So it should be feasible. What is the meaning of this is? Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, person is going from 1 to 3. Then from 3, you have to shift your focus from here to here. 1, 2, 3, no? Then 3 to 2. Okay, you have to write the route. Then 2 to 1. 1, 2, 3. 2 to, okay, 1, 2, 3. From there, you have to start again. 1, 2, 3, no? You are terminating with 3. Then again, you have to start from 3, no? 3 to 2. Then from 2, where is going? 2 to 1. So like that, okay, you have to write 1, 2, 3. From 3 again, 2. Then 2 to 1 like. Feasible as the condition of routing, okay, problem is satisfied. What is the meaning of feasible means? The basic nature of the traveling salesman problem is the person, maybe a medical representative or a salesperson or a tourist, he should start from home city. Anywhere, okay, can start for that matter. So let us assume, okay, he started from one here. Okay. You should come back to the same city. That is happening here. He's starting from one, he is ending his trip or tour at one. And in between, he has not visited any of the cities twice. See, from 1 to 3 is going, 3 to 2, 2 to 1. Fine. This is called feasibility or feasible condition. So apart from that, optimality, no? So you can say whenever number of allocations is equal to order of matrix, it is optimal. But if this condition is also satisfied, then you can say that whatever the solution you got itself is feasible. Optimal as well as feasible. 1 to 3, 3 to 2, 3 to 2, 2 to 1 like. Feasible and optimal, fine. So what is our observation here is, the assignment problem solution itself is optimal and feasible. You please note optimal and you should be feasible also. Hence the optimal and feasible solution is this one. And the cost, no, you have to take 1 to 3, how much it was, 3 to 2, how much, okay, you have to take the parent matrix, okay, as we discussed. 18 units. 18 units means each number is in hundreds of kilometers. No, 1800 kilometers is the solution for this problem. Okay, you please understand the additional constraint of traveling salesman problem as, so the person whoever has started from home city, you should come back to the home city, same home city. That is one thing. And in between cities, he has to cover only once and once. You should not repeat or you should not revisit any of the cities more than once. Fine. Now let us take one more problem. Okay, it is of a different type. I mean, the data is given like this. Solve the traveling salesman problem, that is TSP, given by the following data. C12, C13, C14, and so on is given, where Cij equals to Cji. Cij equals to Cji. First of all, you have to fit this data into the form of rows and columns or into the form of the matrix. Let us see how to put that. Fine. Okay, no doubt, okay, you'll be having 4 cross 4 matrix because highest number that you can see here is 4. Let us write, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Number of rows 4, number of columns 4. In other words, the person is having 4 cities to visit, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, like. Diagonally, you have to put the infinity, that is default. Then what is the meaning of this 1, 2, 2? See, C12 is given as, C stands for cost. 1 to 2 is the position, nothing else, okay? C is the cost, 1 to 2, 1 to 3, they are the positions. So you can see 1 to 2, it is 4, 1 to 3, it is given 7, something like. and Cij equals to Cji. So what is the meaning of this is C13 equals to C31. C13 equals to C31. So our C14 equals to C41, we can say. That is the meaning of Cij equals to Cji. So using this, so you have obtained the, or you have written the matrix form. Fine. After this, the solution part is row reduction. So the procedure is same. Identify the least element in each row and subtract it from other elements. This is row reduction. Then column reduction, identify the least element in each column and subtract it from the other elements. Okay, this is called reduced matrix. Okay, like in assignment, after the two steps, no, the matrix is referred as reduced matrix, which is ready for allocations. Now let us go for the assignments or allocations. So you have to scan the elements row-wise and assigning for zero in a row having single zero and cancel in the respective column. That is Hungarian assignment technique. So first row, okay, if it is having two zeros, no, you have to leave it and you have to go for the second row or third row like that. Okay, if you have done the assignments, no? Okay, I mean if you do the assignments like that, so these are the allocations or assignments. Now what is your observation is number of allocations is equal to order of matrix. How? 1, 2, 3, 4. Number of allocations is equal to order of the matrix. Hence you can say it is optimal. If it was an assignment problem, it was the final solution. No need to check the feasibility. So just what is the declaration of optimality in case of assignment problem is whenever number of allocations is equal to order of matrix, so the solution is optimal. But here, what is the extension or extra part or extra concept is, apart from the optimality, you have to check the feasibility. Feasibility means, so if you write the route, no, it should satisfy the condition of the traveling salesman problem. So that's what I'm repeating. The salesman or the person who has started from city N, no, he should come back to the same city without visiting any city twice. Okay, now, though it is optimal, let us check the feasibility. So how the person is going? 1 to 4. Now, after wherever you are terminating, no, that you have to take. After reaching 4, okay, you have to see this. 4 to 1. I mean, he is going from city 1 to city 4. Then from city 4 to home city, that is city 1, is coming back. That is not permitted. I mean, it's not feasible. So what is happening here? So he is coming back to the home city without visiting or before visiting all the cities. Hence, though it is optimal, it is not feasible. I mean, the route is not feasible. Okay, you should not come back to the home city without visiting or before visiting all the cities. So whenever you get a situation like this, so what to do, we'll see. See, the above routing shows that it is violating the additional constraint of the traveling salesman problem, that is routing. So thus, though it is optimum for an assignment problem, it is not feasible for traveling salesman problem. So in this case, what is my suggestion or the simple way of handling this or obtaining the solution is, so you search for next least element. Okay, obviously one here in this case. You try to form, different routes, different possible routes. So the other possible routes satisfying the additional constraint, taking the next least element to zero. Next least element to zero is one, no? Just okay, like trial and error method it is, fine. You form the possible routes with the next list only. Don't go for other than or beyond next list. Okay, next list means, okay, one, like. You try to just form the routes and evaluate or calculate the route length by that. See, for example, 1 to 4, 4 to 2, it is like solving a puzzle, like 1 to 4, then 4 to 2, that is permitted, no, 1 to 4, 4 to 2, fine. Then let us see, 4 to 2, then 2 to 3, all zeros luckily, fine. Then 3 means all the cities have been covered, you should come back to the home city, 3 to 1. Okay, though it is 1, okay, don't think that, okay, you have to assign only for the zeros in this case, because you have to satisfy the additional constraint called as the feasibility, okay. So then it may take the next least value, that is 1 it is taking, like that. So you try to form the different possible routes, okay, considering the next least element other than the zero. I mean, next list means next to zero, fine. So like that, possibly, okay, you may get three, four possibilities or paths, not more than that, okay? So you just form them, or you write the roots like this. You can observe in all the roots, wherever they started, is coming back to the same place, and no city is repeated in between. See, you can check 1 to 1, in between no number is repeated. So you need not start always at 1 also, or while writing the route, okay, you can start anywhere also, in fact. So okay, if you start, only the condition is wherever it was started, no, the journey, so you should terminate there, like in between, so the cities will be swapped, that's all. See, 3 to 3 in between, 3 to 3. And out of all this, no, okay, all these are feasible. Please note that this is also feasible, this is also feasible, everything is feasible, okay? Feasible, and feasible and optimal, that is the beauty of the optimization, fine? Now, always, okay, you have to find the, what, feasible and optimal. Feasible in the sense, basically it should be feasible, then you have to think of the optimal. See, all these are feasible, okay? Out of this route length, which is the least units, I mean, which is the least distance, 19 units, no. Hence, this you have to declare as feasible and optimal. Simply if it is optimal also, it's not correct. And simply if it is feasible also, it's not correct. It should be feasible and optimal. That's what, the optimal route of the above. Optimal means necessarily it should be feasible. Okay, 1, 4, 3, and the route length is 19 units, fine. So here, in case of traveling salesman problem, you have to check the feasibility first, okay? So then, so you have to, of course, it should be optimal also. Okay, that's all about the traveling salesman problem, or TSP you can abbreviate, or sometimes it's also called as routing problem. Only thing is, by chance, okay, if the assignments that you got, like in first problem, if you are in a position to get the feasibility as a route like this, then whatever you got as the feasible solution, I mean, sorry, as the optimal solution, that itself is feasible. But sometimes, like this, okay, it may be optimal, may not be feasible. In such cases only, you have to think of the next consideration of next least element, because you have to get the feasibility, no? So here, all these are the feasible routes. This one is the feasible and optimal. Okay, now we have discussed about transportation problem and assignment problem in the previous sessions. The methodology, that is obtaining initial basic feasible solution and optimal solution using MODI method. Okay, let us understand, like a mind map, what I can call flow chart. Okay, by using flow chart, the methodology of transportation problem, or the procedure of solving a transportation problem. Okay, we'll start, express the problem in tabular form, that is the formulation, or if it is given, that one directly have to take. Okay, is it balanced problem? Let us take yes first. So whenever sigma supply equal to sigma demand, yes. Then you have to question yourself, is it minimization problem? I mean, standard problem, like, fine, let us say it is yes. Then you have to find initial basic feasible solution using VAM, that is Vogel's approximation method, if nothing is mentioned, or if it is mentioned to use a particular method, no, you have to use that particular method. Okay, this part is IBFS, initial basic feasible solution. Before going to find IBFS, what are the things that you have to check or ensure? So first, okay, you have to have the tabular form, then you have to check whether it is balanced or not, then you have to check whether it is minimization problem or not. If yes, you go for VAM. Then again, what to do? So this is second stage, optimality check. Is M plus N minus 1 is equal to number of allocations? That is a checkpoint for second stage, that is optimality check using MODI or UV method. If it is yes, what to do? So you have to write the equations, that is U's and V's variables, for all the occupied cells. So many equations you will get. And how to compute them? One variable, you have to set it to 0, preferably the variable having more number of allocations. Then for all unoccupied cells, no, for all unoccupied cells, you have to compute net cell evaluations, Dij, let us say delta ij or Dij or something like, which is given by Cij minus Ui plus Vj. U's and V's will compute. No, this is the cost. Okay, once okay, if we get all are greater than or equal to 0, all this Dij or delta Ij are greater than or equal to 0, then you have to say that the solution is optimal. This is one flow, like if no deviations or no special cases are there, so just it will run like this. Okay, just you have to check for balanced state, then whether it is minimization or not, then okay, you have to obtain IBFS, then stage 2, you have to check for m plus n minus 1 equal to number of allocations, obtain U's and V's by framing the equations, then just compute net cell evaluations, that is Dij delta Ij. Once okay, if you get this value is greater than or equal to 0, the solution is optimal. This is a plain problem or a standard problem. But whereas sometimes what will happen, some special cases are there, like maximization problem, unbalanced problem, we discussed, no? Degenerate problem. Let us see. For example, if it is not balanced, so this will be an extra step. We have to balance the problem by adding a dummy row or dummy column accordingly. And again, okay, you have to flow in this direction only, fine? And if it is not minimization problem, let us say it is maximization problem, then what to do? So you have to convert that into standard form, that is minimization form. So what is the procedure? You have to select the highest element and you have to subtract all other elements from it. Okay, then this will be an additional step. So two cases, special cases. This unbalanced, this is maximization problem. Okay, sometimes, no, this one. If it is not equal to this one, m plus n minus 1 is not equal to number of allocations, then you have to introduce a dummy allocation, which is epsilon tends to 0, to a least unoccupied cell, which will not form the closed loop. Okay, this is an extra step. These three are the special cases. So unbalanced, maximization case, then degenerate like, okay, whenever m plus n minus 1 is not equal to number of allocations. Then the last one is, for example, this one, what will happen? So Dij's or delta Ij's, if they are greater than or equal to 0, fine. Okay, you can declare or you can stop the solution there itself. If you get no, I mean if Dij's are not greater than, all Dij's are not greater than or equal to 0, then there is a simple procedure. You have to select the highest negative. If only one negative, that negative itself you have to take. If there are more than one negative values, no. So you have to select the highest negative and you have to form a closed loop, if you remember. So begins and ends at the cell selected, the loop may pass over both occupied and unoccupied cell, but while turning the corners, no, I mean while turning or while taking the deviation, you should have the allocations. Okay, as alternate sign in the root chosen, that's all. Okay, with, I mean loop technology or loop concept you have to use here. So select the least, highest negative cell and you have to form the loop, fine. Then you have to find out the value of x, you have to adjust x value, determine the least value of x, in other words, which must be greater than or equal to 0, then you have to come back to the flow, same flow. Okay, so this will explain everything about the transportation problem. It will address all the aspects of transportation problem, theoretical aspects, as well as the procedure of solving an assignment problem. Okay, just to please compare the stage 1 and stage 2, that is obtaining IBFS using VAM or any method, and obtaining optimal solution using MODI or UA method. So everything is mentioned here. This is one flow. If there are variations, how to tackle? So that has been explained here with the help of a flow chart. This is flow chart for a transportation problem. Similarly, we have a flow chart for an assignment problem also. So assignment problem, okay, again, like start, set up the cost table for problem, that is nothing but formulation. Is it minimization problem? Okay, yes, let us take yes for everything first. Excuse me. Is it balanced problem? Okay, yes, balanced problem in the sense number of rows is equal to number of columns. So then obtain the reduced matrix, row reduction, column reduction. Then allocations, just now also have discussed in case of traveling salesman problem. Okay. So you have to allocate only for the reduced matrix. So once okay, if you get number of allocations is equal to order of matrix, the solution is optimal. This is a regular or plain flow. This is nothing but the methodology of solving an assignment problem using the Hungarian assignment method HAM. Fine. Same thing, the procedure, no? So has been depicted here using the concept of flowchart. Fine. If it is not minimization problem, you have to convert into maximization problem as we discussed in the previous slide. And if it is not balanced also, you have to make it balanced. Fine. Adding a dummy row or dummy column. Okay, here, whenever you get number of allocations is not equal to order of matrix, that is no, if this condition is no, then you have to modify the reduced matrix known as MRM. How to modify the reduced matrix? We have discussed, of course. Identify the least uncrossed element, add this element to the double crossed elements, subtract this elements, from other uncrossed elements. It's a simple two steps or three steps, okay, we'll discuss there in the numerical part. Okay, so then once, okay, for this one, again you have to check for optimality. And once if you get number of allocations is equal to order of the matrix, you have to stop it. That's all. Okay, the solution is optimal, then you have to declare the allocations and you can obtain the cost. Okay, that's all about this session. And coming to the learning objectives, no? Learning objectives were very clear. So to understand the traveling salesman problem, a routing problem, and also to understand the methodology of solving transportation problem and assignment problem by using the flowcharts. See, traveling salesman or routing problem is nothing but assignment problem only with the additional constraint. Additional constraint is nothing but the feasibility constraint. Okay. Once if you form the route, no, so you should be in a position to satisfy the condition of the TSM, TSP or TSM. What is that condition is? The person whoever starts from city N, no, he should come back to the same city without visiting any city twice. Fine. And flow charts, okay, just there for the additional information. So they are like mind maps. You can very easily remember the entire chapter just with this flow chart, like the procedure, no? It is summarized in the form of a flow diagram or flow chart. Fine. So I take this opportunity to thank you one and all. Take care. Have a nice time.